EA Sports. It's in the game.
I'm Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and we welcome you to the MGM Grand here on the Vegas Strip in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada, for tonight's main event. 12 rounds of lightweight action between Sweet Pea Pernell Whitaker and Roberto Duran. Sweet Pea Pernell Whitaker is on his way to the ring right now, and you can see how excited he is for this one. Lots of confidence. Roberto Duran's making his way to the ring right now, puffing out his chest, glaring with those eyes, and taking a big stride to his destination of glory.
Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, Pernell Sweet Pea Whitaker. And his opponents, fighting out of the blue corner, the handsome star, Roberto Duran.
All right, guys, we went over the rules in the dressing room. Have a nice clean fight.
Opening round here, scheduled for 12. When we get matchups like this, guys that just won't quit, they'll be there every step of the way like Gaddy Ward. Sometimes there comes a point where one fighter thinks he's got himself an advantage, he's done something great, but then the other fighter doesn't go away. How does that play out in the minds of each fighter?
Usually it doesn't affect the kind of guys you just mentioned, Gaddy and Ward. They made how to cement these guys. They're already set in their ways. They know what they have to do. They're not gonna get thrown off just because somebody's still there.
Sweet Pea, sweet block. See, the defense pays off as he gets rid of that downstairs. Oh, that's good stuff. Firing right back with one of his own. Good work by Roberto Duran. Oh, and there you go. Roberto Duran stunned, and he is hurt. Duran with a block.
Hit it out, hit it out.
Seconds to go here in this round. Locks that belt line well. Roberto Duran's got a bad cut now that's opened up on his cheek. Locks the headshot. And he returns on that exchange. 60 seconds to go in what has been a toe-to-toe war. Oh, what a great round. Roberto Duran starting to bleed from the nose. Good good block by Durant. Right on the mark, both guys with the hook. Very clean offense from defense by Pernell Whitaker. Well, he took one right there, but then he targeted one right back.
What does a fighter need to do to really build a foundation to a great career?
Well, first of all, they have to have the desire to have that great career. There has to be something in them. There has to be coal in that furnace to burn, and to burn later on. Maybe something happened to them in their life. Maybe through their parents, maybe through neighbors, maybe through coaches. Somebody told them they were never gonna make it. And they go in their mind that they're gonna find a way to make those people wrong.
Don't worry about it. The swelling is nothing. Just...
So here we are, a new round underway, and in that last round, he got tagged. He got hit pretty hard, Teddy.
Yeah, he did. He got caught. Now, the first thing is, we all know he got caught, but why did he get caught? He has to be able to decipher that in his head. He has to be able to have the answer to that so it doesn't happen again.
Good counter punch by Roberto Durant. Halfway through round number two. Oh, and he's got something for him himself, and it's a left hand. Each man able to land an uppercut. Not what he was looking for. That's a miss right there by Pernell Whitaker. Away from those headshots with his defense up top. Oh, that's gotta hurt. Roberto Durant's been stunned.
No holding.
A hook for you and a hook right back. Sweet piece, sweet block. Durant with a block.
Get on that.
Back to fight action as a new round is underway. Of course, in that last round, it was fairly one-sided. He was hit pretty hard, and now he has to overcome that here.
Yeah, you don't have to be Nostradamus to know that. I mean, everybody saw, you know, he got staggered, his knees buckled, did a little dance there. But what you have to really know now is know why you got hit and correct that immediately.
Keeps his hands up defensively, protecting the head. Able to dismiss his opponent's shot, and then comes back with an uppercut. He has walked through bullets, bazookas, and bombs, and he's still standing in there tonight, Teddy.
Yeah, this is a testament not just to the physical makeup. I know a lot of people at home are going to say, wow, what kind of bone does he have inside that chin? But it's his mind, too. He's making a choice, just like you do in life and other things. He's making a choice to deal with this. A lot of guys would have given in already.
Cover your head, kid. You can see there's blood on his cheek. Coming to the halfway point of this third round. That's what Sweet Pea does best. Good count. Wow! Pernell Whitaker's been stunned.
All right, come on now. Come on, work it out. Work it out. See some punches here.
Takes one, but gives one. Good work by Roberto Duran. He was stunned, but now he's surviving. Able to cover up that gut. Good counterpunch by Roberto Duran. He has taken a lot of punishment here.
Well, the special fighters find a way, even when it's desperate like this, to survive. He's got to find that way right now.
Comes right back with a shot of his own. Oh, and he comes back with an uppercut there after getting hit. Pernell Whitaker with a counterpunch. He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left hand scores.
Defense, more defense.
Coming to the end of this round, Joe and Teddy with you ringside. Teddy, a round like that where it's a lot of busy activity and both guys being busy, when you were a trainer, are those the kind of rounds that you prefer, or do you like the pace to be a little slower? Does it depend on each guy?
No, if I have a fighter, I'd rather have a guy fighting a guy that you never see him. Leave me the heck alone, and where I'm in control all the time. But the fans love to see a fight like that.
So here we are, a new round underway, and in that last round, he got tagged. He got hit pretty hard, Teddy.
Yeah, he did. He got caught. Now, the first thing is, we all know he got caught, but why did he get caught? He has to be able to decipher that in his head. He has to be able to have the answer to that so it doesn't happen again.
Covers up nicely, gets rid of his opponent's body shot. Good clean shot, returning fire. Well done by Roberto Duran. Parries that punch intended for the head. Well, he's got to be careful here, Teddy, because I know he was stunned earlier, and he wants to tie up, he wants to clinch.
But at that moment where you go to clinch, you're creating an opening.
Yeah, you are. Your opponent can take advantage of that. He can take a little step back, make you fall in, and then bang, 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 put you in even worse shape.
Halfway through round number four. Duran with a block. Both men trading hooks. Able to cover up along the belt line, blocks that one. Bleeding from his cheek. Good block by Duran. That was a miss by Pernell Whitaker. Good counter punch by Roberto Duran. Thought he had his target, but way off to the side with the uppercut. Able to dismiss that body shot. And this round comes to an end. It is a round that was highly entertaining. These guys really put forth quite an effort.
Well, they both have high engines. They have motors that never stop going.
That's been very entertaining, but I wouldn't want to be a judge. This is one of those fights that could go either way. Good block by Sweet Pea. Now, this is a very exciting fight. It's been evenly fought, but it just has the feel of a fight that's going to go the distance. It doesn't look like any one guy is going to take control over the other.
No, when somebody makes up their mind, I am not being knocked out, I am staying, they usually stay. These guys are here for the night.
Oh, he took some damage, but he gave some back with the right hand. Boy, just staying on the outside, away from danger and scoring well. Good work on the outside from him.
And that was set up by his inside fighting earlier. A place where, quite honestly, I expected him to be all night long. But now he's getting the privilege. He's getting the luxury of being able to stay outside a little bit.
Able to dismiss his opponent's shot and then comes back with an uppercut. I would assume there has to come a point in this fight where he has to make the commitment to throw the power punches. It's hard to envision a way he's going to win this fight without going down that road.
He doesn't have the confidence to do it. I don't know if he's mentally strong enough to do it. I think he's worried about throwing hard at the guy because maybe in his mind that means the guy will throw hard back at him.
There on the punch by Pernell Whitaker. Does it surprise you that he's not going to the body as much as he could be?
Well, what surprises me is that he doesn't have the intuitiveness, you know, just the instinct to understand, to recognize the situation. That's part of the ability of a good fighter, to recognize what he should be doing in a certain situation. He's not seeing that. He should be going downstairs.
A little give and take, and here comes the left hand. He missed that uppercut. Teddy, you know what I'm so impressed by? Obviously, the pace of this fight is just ridiculous. But how hungry these guys are, how badly each guy wants it.
Joe, this is the kind of fight that it has nothing to do about money. It has everything to do about legacy, how they're going to be remembered.
What a good war this has been. What a good, good, solid fight it's been. The kind of fight that tells me somebody wants to get rid of the other guy.
It almost looks like they made a deal where neither one could win by decision, where if they didn't win by knockout, it doesn't count.
Listen, you're not giving me enough punches, okay? Throw more punches, jab, jab, hook.
Live action now in what has been a closely contested fight. One of those fights that somebody is still waiting to break through and be a difference maker in. Straight right was lined up, but he missed. Teddy, I guess they wanted it. Look at this action going right out there, wasting no time.
No, these guys are impatient. They couldn't wait to get at each other.
Pernell Whitaker. That worked out really well. Throwing off the right hand after getting tagged like that. Right on the mark, both guys with the hook. Halfway through what is one of the best rounds you'll ever see. Just great action.
No, it's unbelievable. I mean, if you love roller coasters, you go to an amusement park. If you want to see left hooks, right hands, every direction, great chins, great endurance, great heart, you come to this fight. You stay right here.
Duran, he's got a real problem on his hands now, Teddy. I think the cut is actually worsening around his eye. He has to do a better job of watching out for that. He has to protect that eye.
Yeah, what he has to do now is give his corner man, his cut man, a chance for his work to be accomplished. In other words, there's been coagulants, chemicals put into that eye. Now the fighter has to move a little bit, be elusive, and allow those chemicals, those medicines to work.
Gets rid of that body shot. Well, obviously what his opponent has done here is the reason that cut is in the shape that it's in. So if you're him, just keep doing what you're doing?
Yes and no, Joe. Of course, it's easy to say, yeah, keep doing what you're doing. But what if there's a little change? Your opponent's cut now, he's gonna move his head, you figure, a little bit to survive in there. Now you shouldn't go head hunting, even though that cut's there. Now you have to adjust to what's in front of you. Go downstairs to the body.
Wow! Roberto Duran stunned, and he is hurt. Really fun-looking fight so far here. We've reached the halfway mark. Teddy, your impressions as to what we're gonna see in the second half of this fight?
More of the same. I don't think these fighters know how to do anything, at least tonight. They came here with this mentality, and you know what? You can't really change gears at this point. You're gonna see more of the same.
Don't worry about it. We'll take care of the cut. There's nothing, a small cut, nothing to worry about. Let's get on this one. Get the compressor.
Back to fight action as a new round is underway. Of course, in that last round, It was fairly one-sided. He was hit pretty hard, and now he has to overcome that here.
Yeah, you don't have to be Notre Dame to know that. I mean, everybody saw, you know, he got staggered, his knees buckled, did a little dance there. But what you have to really know now is know why you got hit and correct that immediately.
There's the headshot, but he parries it away. Good block by Durant. The headshot. Roberto Duran's dealing with the aftermath of being rocked, but yet he hasn't changed anything. He's still sticking with that style.
Well, that means panic has not set in. That's a good thing, Joe. He still believes he can get this thing done the way he came here to get it done.
Protect the midsection. Oh, look at that. They exchange hooks. What a great round. 2 minutes in, 60 seconds to go. Able to cover up along the belt line, blocks that one. Good counter punch by Roberto Duran. Roberto Duran's not sticking to his style at all. He got away from what had gotten him in trouble. Remember, he was rocked earlier.
Yeah, it's like being in the Grand Prix, you know, you're in that race, and all of a sudden you pull to the pitch and you say, you know what, I gotta change my tires. You know, I'm just not getting traction out here. You know, he almost went into a wall. Well, he's changing his tires, changing his plan.
Oh, a big, big body shot. What a nice counter that was. End of the round is upon us. And if the next round holds up like that, we're going to be in for a real treat.
No, we will be, because both these guys have the philosophy that their best defense is their offense.
All right. Let's work on that cut. It's nothing. The cut's nothing. Don't worry about it. If you're standing straight up, move that body. You need to move.
As another round gets underway, it gets us thinking, how much more of this will we see? Hard to envision this fight going the distance with how lopsided it's been. Doing well on the outside. Well, all of us can see the success he's having with the uppercut. How come his opponent can't? What should he be looking for?
Well, what he needs to do is he has to be aware where it's coming. He knows it comes when he's inside and it's coming up the middle. He needs to take his glove and just dip it down, drop it a little bit, open it up, and kind of put it underneath his chin a little bit to block that punch.
Punching there with the overhand right. Very nice defensive guard there. Yeah. block by Durant. One hook deserves another. Wow. He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left hand scores. A minute to go in what has been a memorable round. Great stuff from these two. Roberto Duran's got a bad cut now that's opened up on his cheek. That's what sweep he does best. Good counter punch. He's just covering up. That's all he's doing. But it gives his opponent so much time to pick where he isn't.
Yeah, you're right, Joe. I mean, first of all, some of them are going to get through and some of them are watching them. They're getting through. And you just touched on it. I mean, you cover up. You tell your opponent, hey, I'm camping out. I'm not throwing back. So instead of throwing one or two at you, he's throwing combinations of three, four, five. You got a problem.
We come to the end of the round. A round that I'm having a tough time trying to think about who won. I can only imagine what the judges are thinking about. Teddy, if there's one thing you look for in a round like that and say, okay, I'm going to give it to this guy over this guy, what is it?
Well, the first thing is, if I'm a judge, I take a little notepad and I make a little markdown, blue or red corner, what he did early. Because sometimes a judge has a tendency to forget what was done early and only go with what went late.
All right. Then we're going to cut you. Let's get on that swelling.
The ninth round of this good fight. Big headshot puts him down.
One, two, three, four, five.
And somehow, some way, he's gonna continue on here.
And if he's gonna stay in this fight, now he's gonna avoid his opponent like the Black Plague.
Gets rid of that. It was intended for his head. Now Whitaker's getting caught with headshots. Teddy, to me this is pretty simple. Move your head.
Otherwise the other guy will. And he's been moving his head for him all night.
Hernell Whitaker's got a way of just getting away from that punch. Great fight. I mean, just a great fight. Both guys giving their all back and forth.
It doesn't get much better.
Oh, Roberto Duran's almost out of it there. He was stunned. Good block by Duran. Oh! Roberto Duran! And he crashes to the canvas once again. He's gotten up before. What about this time? Whitaker's gonna have his hand raised by way of KO. The 10 count reached, his opponent out, he's the victor. MVP, Pernell Whitaker's your winner by knockout, Teddy.
Well, we came in wondering whether or not his opponent had a good chin. We found out.
Thanks for being with us, everybody. For Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. Have yourself a great night. Hi, everybody. So glad you're with us. Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and we welcome you to the MGM Grand here on the Vegas Strip in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada, for tonight's main event. 12 rounds of welterweight action between Ricky the Hitman Hatton and Paulie Malignaggi. Ricky Hatton's ring walks have become the stuff of legend, and you can see the intensity on his face. Paulie Malignaggi's coming down to the ring, and you can tell with that zip in his step that he plans on this one being a spectacular evening for him.
Fighting out of the blue corner, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ricky the Hitman Hatton. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner, Paulie the Magic Man.
All right, gentlemen, protect yourself at all times. Let's touch him up.
The opening bell of this scheduled 12-rounder here. A much-anticipated fight. Round one underway.
When a high-stamina fighter is fighting another guy who's very well-conditioned, is there any tendency for maybe some doubts to creep into his mind?
Yeah, there always are. Because you always want to have the edge. We're human beings. Boxers are no different. They want to say they have a little edge in that area. But they need to know that this is exactly what they're ready to do.
After catching one by Ricky Hatton. Able to block that away. It was targeted for his head. Able to get away from that headshot with the block. Oh, good exchange there. Good block. Takes one but gives one. Good work by Ricky Hatton. Blocks the headshot. He took a go of it to the body but came up empty. Whatever game plan and strategy they may have come in. Oh, that's gotta hurt. Oh, that uppercut got him badly. Ricky Hatton's swelling will have to be dealt with immediately. Good clean shot, returning fire. Well done by Ricky Hatton. Digs in with a good solid uppercut after taking a shot. He was stunned and staggered moments ago. Now he's right back in the fight looking pretty good.
Yeah, some guys take a little longer to recover. One of his strengths is he recovers real fast.
Would you rather have a fighter who's feared or a fighter who's fearless?
I feel like I'm talking to Sonny from the Bronx Tale. But I think that I would rather have a guy that has fear because he's going to be smart all the time. He's going to be a guy that's going to be aware of things that you need to be aware of. If he's so-called fearless, he's going to walk into all kinds of things that are not going to allow him to be a fighter.
Targeting the hooks on each man. Parries that punch intended for the head. Final 10 seconds of round number one. They trade shots. He comes back with a right hand. So we come to the end of the round. and clearly a confidence booster for this man. He got to his opponent. He was able to stun him. Teddy, when a fighter comes back after doing what he just did, do you see them almost light up, like get a little boost of energy because of that?
Yeah, it does build your confidence a little bit. You know, it makes you feel more secure. I can control this man. I had my way.
Nice. Good work. I want to see you double up that jab. Okay?
So here we are, a new round underway, and in that last round, he got tagged. He got hit pretty hard, Teddy.
Yeah, he did. He got caught. Now, the first thing is, we all know he got caught, but why did he get caught? He has to be able to decipher that in his head. He has to be able to have the answer to that so it doesn't happen again.
Able to dismiss his opponent's shot, and then comes back with an uppercut. Locks it away. The exchange was something special. Well, that's exactly what you should be doing on the inside. If you want a punch and you need space, do what you have to do to get that space. He's pushing him around. Nice strike after catching one by Pauly Malignaggi. Fine work right there by Hatton.
How is he able to do this? How is he able to take these shots?
You know, one time Muhammad Ali talked about taking a chin. He had one of the great chins of all time. And what he basically talked about was that when you start to get hit those shots, you start to go down a hallway. And then you go into a gray room. You go from a light room to a gray room. And at the end of the hallway, you see a dark room. You don't want to go to that dark room. And you have a choice. You put your feet down, you start backing up. I'm not going to that dark room. This guy is not being taken to that dark room.
Able to cover up along the belt line, blocks that one. We saw Ricky Hatton rise to prominence, getting through some of the B-level guys among the 140 pounders. Guys like Joe Hutchinson, Cool Vince Phillips, and Ben Tacky, and Mike Stewart, and Super Ray Oliveira. But his coming out party, I mean, his big moment was the upset of Kostya Szew.
Yeah, you know, and it was an upset in a lot of dimensions. Not just that he won, he was the underdog going in there, even though it was on home turf, but a huge, huge upset that the way he won. Kostya Szew basically gave up. He was broken down by the relentless style of Hatton.
His opponent wanted the body. He wouldn't give it to him. You see guys do this all the time. A little shove off there to create some space on the inside and get your punches off. And this round comes to an end. It is a round that was highly entertaining. These guys really put forth quite an effort.
Well, they both have high engines. They have motors that never stop going.
Throwing off the tempos. That's it. Throwing them off with that movement.
Get the compress on. Let them work on this one. Let them work on it.
And round number three is underway. Blocks away that headshot. Tucks those elbows in, blocks the body shot. A little give and take, and here comes. Oh, that's gotta hurt. Pauly Malignaggi stunned, and he is hurt. Covers up nicely, gets rid of his opponent's body shot.
Get out of the way from those punches.
Frustrating his opponent with great defense.
comes from a family of soccer players. In fact, his grandfather and his father were part of the Manchester City team, and Ricky himself was put down that path originally, Teddy, but things didn't pan out. He stumbled across and was inspired by the sport of boxing, stumbling across a boxing gym, and for the better. Good decision.
Yes, it is. And you know, that's one of the things that the old-time trainers used to tell me. With boxing, there's a weight class, there's a place for everybody. Size has nothing to do with it. You can be a world champ.
Hatton able to block a punch.
Takes one, but gives one. Good work by Ricky Hatton. Able to cover up along the belt line, blocks that one. Halfway through this round here. Paulie Malignaggi's cut is right near his eye. That's the last place his corner's going to want to see any damage. You see guys do this all the time, a little shove off there to create some space on the inside and get your punches off. Good block. 1 minute to go in a round that feels like an all-time classic. Punch for punch, they're meeting each other. Very nice work from both men. They each got a shot in. Paulie Malignaggi's doing a good job of putting his punches together. His opponent's got to be wondering, how do I stop this?
Well, right now, you made a good point there, because right now his opponent is wondering too much. You know, he's just busy blocking the punches, wondering about the combinations. He's not getting off.
Ricky Hatton's got to deal with a cut on his cheek right now. The good news is it's below the eye, but still, it can get nasty as the fight progresses. Showing you some defense there with the block. A little give and take, and here comes the left hand. End of the round there. He was able to stun his opponent. Teddy, when you're training a guy that's coming off a round where he just got to his man, what do you do? Do you say, hey, I saw that, and here's how you did it? How do you approach that?
Well, you want to make sure you remind them exactly what you're talking about, how he set it up. Don't think about just the big punch that landed. Remember how you got to that point.
Let's get it in. Stay tight and bang away. Bang away.
Back to fight action as a new round is underway. Of course, in that last round, it was fairly one-sided. He was hit pretty hard, and now he has to overcome that here.
Yeah, you don't have to be Notre Dame to know that. I mean, everybody saw, you know, he got staggered, his knees buckled, did a little dance there. But what you have to really know now is know why you got hit and correct that immediately.
Good job by drawing in his opponent and then landing the counterpunch by Hatton. Teddy, I guess they wanted it. Look at this action going right out there, wasting no time.
No, these guys are impatient. They couldn't wait to get at each other.
Paulie Malignaggi's just being very hesitant right now offensively. His first thought since being stunned in this fight is protect myself, protect myself. It's like he's turned the off switch on his offense.
Yeah, but you can't do that. The lights go off, it gets all dark there. You have to find a way to still have that light on. You know, find the window of opportunity somewhere. They are out there, be creative.
Blocks that belt line well. He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left hand scores. Good block by Hatton. He tried to nab him up top, but was unable to connect. Oh, he just misses with that headshot. Good defense, just covering up down low. What a great job. He gave one right back in return. Nice work by Paulie Malignaggi. Nice block by Ricky Hatton.
Neither man slowing down as we have 60 seconds to go in this round.
Keep working the body.
Good block by Pauly. Here's one for you now, he says. Right back with the left hand.
Ricky Hatton's eye to me is getting worse as things continue on here. Teddy, he's got to be very conscious of that, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does, and his corner has to be too. They got to be thinking about if it gets to the point where he can't defend himself, they have to do something. Obviously, they didn't come here thinking they were going to have to do stop this fight.
Able to block that away. It was targeted for his head. Round comes to an end. And that's one of those rounds, Teddy, that just takes on a certain style, a certain characteristic, and that was a busy one.
Yeah, it was a busy one. Look, Joe, you don't have to look for these guys. They're right there in front of you.
Why do you think that is? Why do you think sometimes you just get those rounds where it all happens?
Because of styles. You know, styles make fights. In this case, you're seeing proof of that right there. Both guys that are aggressive, both guys that are very confident.
Don't walk into him without throwing a punch.
Another round underway, but how many more will we see? You get the sense this fight could be heading towards a stoppage. A good block by Ricky Hatton. A crafty counterpunch after a fine defensive effort by Ricky Hatton. Teddy, you know what I'm so impressed by? Obviously, the pace of this fight is just ridiculous. But how hungry these guys are, how badly each guy wants it.
Joe, this is the kind of fight that it has nothing to do about money. It has everything to do about legacy, how they're going to be remembered.
Well, he missed that right. Ricky Hatton blocks that punch. Takes one to give one. Uppercut in return. Devastating blow by Hatton. Teddy, this is one of those moments where you just wish you could pick up the phone and call up the world and say, tune in. Everybody should be watching this, right?
I have a cell phone. I might do that right now.
Start dialing. He returns the favor with a right hand of his own. Staying away from those headshots with his defense up top. Showing a little bit of a defensive shell, but Teddy, I'm seeing punches still getting through and splitting that guard.
Yeah, well, that's the problem, Joe, when you put those earmuffs on, but you don't move your head. Some of them are going to get through, and just as importantly, you handcuff yourself, so your opponent is going to stay in there a little bit longer, knowing that nothing's coming back right away.
Blocks that punch. Ricky Hatton's now battling two opponents. The guy standing opposite him trying to punch him, and his eyes swelling.
Yeah, he can't see what's coming at him right now.
Not hitting his mark there, going upstairs. Good looking counter punch by Pauly.
Come.
right there. Boom! You just focus on the fight. You take care of this fight. Get on that. Get on that.
They are back to action here, but that action has only favored one man. Completely one. Oh, Ricky Hatton's down! Find a way. He went down and now beating the count and looking to continue and survive.
Well, I think a lot of us wanted to find out what would happen when this moment came, if it did come. Right now, Pat wants to find out too.
Good defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault. Well, I don't know if he's hip to the idea of becoming a counterpuncher, but I get the sense you'd agree with it.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, he's got the perfect platform, the perfect form for it. The guy's walking in right now, not moving his head much. He can time him, he can counter him.
He missed with that headshot. Able to land an uppercut. Nice block by Ricky Hatton. See, he's got his guard up really well that time, and it protects his head. Wow, just sit back and enjoy this one. You can tell both guys are so determined to give everything they have here tonight.
So it's like the first time you heard Ray Charles sing God Bless America. You knew it was special. You knew you hadn't heard it before. I haven't seen anything like this before.
With a counterpunch. Paulie Malignaggi's jab doing wonders again. Teddy, what's it done for him in this fight?
Well, it's set up everything. I mean, start with the defense. He's kept his opponent defensive. He's kept him to the point where he's not so aggressive anymore. And also, it set up his power shots.
With a left hand.
Don't let him breathe. He's cut. Get him this round. The jab was good. Don't use it enough. Jump.
Don't worry about it. We'll take care of it. Cut. There's nothing. Small cut. Nothing to worry about. Get on that.
Over the hump, the back end of the fight now begins. Oh, he just misses with that headshot. Every gym's got one of those double-ended backs, right? They give you the movement, you gotta hit that moving target, work on your accuracy. He's making it so that his opponent never had to work on one, Teddy. He's just sitting right there, right in front, no head movement whatsoever.
No, not at all. He didn't have one in his gym, that's for sure, because he just does not know how to move his head. The old-timers would say he gets insulted if you miss him.
Paulie Malignaggi staying away from trouble. He's out there on the outside. Good counterpunching there with the overhand right. They are bringing out the best in each other. I mean, you can just tell when they meet up in the middle of this ring, they're bringing out the best in each other. Malignaggi with a counterpunch. Yeah, Good looking counter punch by Paulie. Just missed with that punch. Paulie Malignaggi's in position right now to really bring home a good victory. He's up on the punch stats. He's up on your scorecard. This is his fight.
Yeah, we just hope that the judges, and you never know that. That's one thing that sometimes can really disappoint you in this business. You hope the judges see it that way, because I can't see it any other way.
Blocks that belt line well. A good block by Ricky Hatton. Nothing there on the punch by Hatton. So he went down earlier, and yet he's still fighting with the same kind of style, the same kind of disposition he was fighting with before the knockdown. If I'm the opponent, maybe that's a sign to me that, hey, maybe I didn't hurt the guy that much.
Or maybe it's a sign that this son of a gun is just very predictable. He can't change. And maybe I'm going to have a party tonight, because I'm going to keep catching with the same thing until he takes it away from me.
That's a good point. Not hitting his mark there, going upstairs. Blocks the headshot. Nice block by Ricky Hatton. This has been a hotly contested war throughout, and you just have a sense that it's gonna end at any moment in these later rounds.
Yeah, these guys are not saving anything. They're going for broke right from the beginning.
Don't worry about it. Just take care of it. We'll take care of the cut. It's nothing. The phone got nothing to worry about. Let's get on that swell. I'll press up.
You know, he looks good. He looks ready to go. We'll see what he can offer up in this round. Good, strong uppercut. He comes right back with it after taking one. Good job by drawing in his opponent and then landing the counterpunch by Hatton. Up nicely, gets rid of his opponent's body shot. Solid counter punch by Ricky Hatton to land that counter punch and getting away from one of his own by Hatton. Tried to land that upstairs and was off the mark. You would think Hatton would be getting the better of it here on the inside, but that's not the case at all.
No, but what it comes down to in any athlete's career is a moment where sometimes you have to make an adjustment. Do something you've never had to do before. Hatton's going to have to figure out another way to go about his business.
With a good solid uppercut after taking one. A minute to go in what has been a memorable round. Great stuff from these two. A good block by Ricky Hatton. Unable to land that shot. anybody will tell you, you can't get away with that. What a big, wide, sweeping whiff that was.
Well, you can get away with it if the guy doesn't want to throw back, but if this guy wants to start throwing back, then you're not getting away with it.
That worked out really well, throwing off the right hand after getting tagged like that. Malignaggi with the block punch.
Nice work. Listen, once you go downstairs, downstairs, okay? Body and hands. Let's finish this. Get the confidence.
We're gonna cut. Let's get on that swelling.
The action starts up again, but it's only favored one man. Hard to see this fight going the distance based on what we've witnessed so far. How about a return to sender with the left hand? There's the headshot, but he parries it away. You see guys do this all the time, a little shove off there to create some space on the inside and get your punches off. Really wanted that uppercut, but just couldn't get it. A little defense turns to offense by Hatton. Well, here's the way we see it. He's down on the scorecards, has to have the knockout to win it.
Yeah, and he has to understand that. You know, the main thing is he hasn't given in. You know, he's still there trying, but he's in a desperate place. So what he has to do now is look for one spot. He remembers maybe something he saw early in the night where the guy pulls out his hand down a little bit and maybe he can time him stepping out.
Block that time. It was intended to the head. A well-placed, gutsy uppercut after being tagged. Able to cover up that gut. It's been 2 minutes of non-stop action. Now the final minute has arrived. Showing you some defense there with the block. This is why we love the sport, Teddy. I mean, this is just back and forth action nonstop.
Well, Joe, with special events have happened in history, you remember where you are. Right now, I'm gonna remember where I was during this fight. I'm watching a special epic right in front of me.
Glad to be here doing it, too. What a war this is. Oh, and there you go. Paulie Malignaggi's in a bad place right now. He was tagged. So far tonight, he was being completely outworked, but now we see him being more the aggressor.
Well, we're starting to get a little late. He understood he needed to change things a little.
End of the round here, and as I glance around ringside and look at the judges, I'm wondering what they're writing down, because that was a tough round to score.
Yeah, it was, and you know, it's the kind of round where one guy would be really smart to take a page out of the book of Sugar Ray Leonard, Marvin Hagler, where Leonard stole rounds at the end, where he just clipped off 30 seconds, and that's exactly what the judges remembered.
All right. Let's work on that cut. It's not. That's nothing. Don't worry about it.
Your fight is fight. Jab and move. 10.
Another round underway, but how many more will we see? You get the sense this fight could be heading towards a stoppage.